Hi, I'm Sharon Bill. Welcome to my Theory Tuition series, where we're working together step by step through each of the ABRSM theory grades. There are lots of resources available to help you on my website. If you visit sharonbill.com, you'll find some free PDF information sheets. They're available in US letter or A4, and they accompany each step of this series. There's also a page with links to all of my YouTube video tutorials, and you can also find information about the books I have available. I've written How to Take Your ABRSM Music Theory Exam, which is full of tips and techniques on how to best prepare for your exam, and also how to best make use of the time when you're actually working through your exam paper on exam day. So if you visit sharonbill.com, it's all there for you. If you can give me a like, that'd be really encouraging to me. I hope you're enjoying this as much as I am. And please subscribe to my channel to keep updated. We're looking at the last sections of this grade 4 now. So if you want to turn with me to page 43, right at the back of your book, and we're going to be looking at performance directions, excuse me, and we're going to refer to this as section M, and so you know to look in your PDF documents at section M. There we go, so we're going to be looking at that as well, and also over the page in your PDF booklet as well. So we're looking at performance directions. Now please do bear in mind that these are all the performance directions, Italian terms and so on, that have already been included in grades 1, 2 and 3. So it's all of those grades plus this new information. Remember, it's accumulative, so it's always drawing on previous knowledge as well. So the new information that we've got at first are these performance signs relating to the instruments that we've talked about in the previous video. So it's things like knowing that brass can have mutes or no mutes, and looking at the Italian terms for that. Of course, strings are played with a bow, the violin, the viola, the cello and the double bass. So we need to learn about these bowing directions. Or also if there's no bow used and it's pizzicato plucked, we need to think about which strings are being played. And also, sometimes we can be told where to play on the instrument as well, playing nearer to the bridge. Each of these gives a different instrumental effect that the composer wants, particularly in his music. Also, it's being aware of piano directions. A piano actually falls in the percussion instrument section, not the string instruments. Although it's got strings in it, it's referred to as a percussion instrument because basically the hammers hit the strings and that makes it fall into the percussion group. And then we've got these pedaling directions where we have to press the left pedal, which causes just one string to start, it dampens the other strings. If we need to release the left pedal, it puts us back on three strings, hence this symbol here. We've got pedaling directions which can be written on the music telling us to lift the pedal up or depress the pedal. Sometimes we've even got signs telling us which hand to use, because sometimes we can be crossing hands. And then we've got this arpeggiated sign where we build up a chord gradually. It sort of gives the effect of like a harp sort of glissando as we arpeggiate the chords. So it's just taking time to get to use to these sort of instrumental directions. And then if you turn over the page, we find that we've now got, in addition to all the Italian terms from grades 1, 2 and 3, we've got these new Italian terms to learn. And then we've also got some French terms to learn. The French words tend to come into music, sort of like impressionist, more modern music, sort of Debussy and so on, would use these terms, breaking away from just using the Italian. So there's quite a lot to go at there, and my advice to you would be to compile a list from all of your grades 1, 2, 3 and now 4 as well, but don't compile it in alphabetical order, as it is here in each of your other books as well, but break it down into thematic groups. You could even colour code those groups. So anything to do with slow or tenderly, of all of the grades you can group together. So you learn some word associations rather than just trying to find lots of abstract definitions. When it comes in alphabetical order, it's not necessarily the most memorable way. So group it thematically would be my advice, and even colour code it, whatever it takes to help you to get to know these words. And also get sort of creative in your revision techniques. Play all sorts of games. You can play word games to just help you to remember these, and you know, rope in a friend to help you to revise and test you on these. If you turn over the page in your PDF document, I've compiled a little test. And so when you feel ready, have a go. And this is a little test bringing in words from all of the previous grades and this grade. So just a little spot check test there, just to help you to monitor your progress in learning these words. My advice would be, when you feel like you're ready to have a go, try this entirely without looking up any answers at all. And if you don't know, guess, because you'll learn better by your mistakes. If you just keep looking up and copying, it's quite a passive way of revising and it doesn't sink in so securely. If you just test yourself, and even if you get it hilariously wrong, it doesn't matter, you've had a go. And whilst you're sort of scratching your head and thinking about it, it's really helping you to dig in and learn that thoroughly. So really, that section is quite a heavy section, but it's down to you. I can't really help you too much with that. It's just a matter of taking time to group those words thematically, learn them, and just a process, gradually, bit by bit, you'll get to grips with these terms. So I hope that's helpful to you there. If you can give me a like, that would be really encouraging to me. Please subscribe to my channel to keep updated. There's still plenty more to come. And please do visit sharonbill.com and make use of all the resources available there to help you. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.